In this video, we'll explore the relationship between elasticities and revenue. Specifically, we'll look at the relationship between price, cross, and income elasticities of demand and revenue. If you need a refresher on the relationship between total revenue and elasticity, I'll put the link to the earlier video published in the information section below. At this point in your studies, you should be familiar with the idea that a firm facing inelastic demand should raise prices to increase its total revenue. If the firm faces elastic demand for its product, it should decrease price to increase total revenue. Cross-elasticity of demand helps because a firm can use its knowledge of substitutes and complements in developing competitive strategies. If substitutes are falling in price and there is a strong relationship between the two products, a firm should strongly consider a competitive strategy to avoid a loss of revenue. If the price of Coca-Cola falls, then Pepsi should consider a strategy in response. In the case of complementary goods, a producer should consider how an increase in the price of a complement will impact their sales. For example, if the price of petrol rises, a car manufacturer should consider how it will affect car sales. Toyota, like most manufacturers, sells larger and smaller cars. They also sell electric cars. If the price of petrol rises, they may expand their electric car offerings. Again, this depends on many things, including how high petrol prices rise and how long they are expected to remain high. In the case of income elasticity of demand, a firm can use estimates to determine how the demand for their product will change with respect to changes in income. If they produce inferior goods, such as instant noodles, then they should consider increasing production when incomes fall. If a firm is producing normal or luxury goods, they should consider increasing production when incomes rise. When evaluating the impact of a specific elasticity on a firm, it is important to remember that in the real world, price changes are often not the only changing variable in the business environment. There could be other factors at play, including changes in tastes, preferences, income, advertising, weather, or a host of other factors. You also have to consider the source of the data and its validity. If the information is older, it's less valid, and if it was collected improperly, there are likely to be issues in making projections based on it. Rivals are also likely to respond to whatever changes the firm makes, resulting in further action being necessary. Finally, elasticity estimates are not static because consumer responsiveness changes over time. At best, they're what they are called, estimates. By now, you should have a deeper understanding of the relationship between price, cross, and income elasticities of demand and revenue. If you need more help understanding this connection, leave a comment or email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com.